Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about tocilizumab. What is this drug tocilizumab? Here we can draw the suffix jumab, and the last three letters of this suffix indicates mab, which is nothing but monoclonal antibody. And the letters ZU indicates this drug is humanized. So tocilizumab is a humanized monoclonal antibody. And this drug acts as interleukin-6 receptor antagonist. So IL-6 interleukin-6 is one of the inflammatory mediator which is released by stimulation of immune response. So when the T cells are activated, IL-6 is released along with other inflammatory mediators, and this cytokine can produce inflammatory response. Now tocilizumab is acting as antagonist at these IL-6 receptors, thereby it reduces immunity, resulting in immunosuppression. By this, the inflammation is also reduced. So this drug is used to reduce the inflammation and to control the immune response. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about this tocilizumab, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, contraindications, and clinical use of this drug we will discuss in this video. One of the important indication of tocilizumab is in the COVID-19 infection. This coronavirus can stimulate the immunity and it can promote the T cell activity, and these T cells can release a variety of cytokines. So when these cytokines are suddenly released, they can produce cytokine storm in the patients. Since cytokines produce inflammation, and when they are not controlled, they can produce severe inflammation, leading to the damage of many of the organs in the body. In order to control this cytokine storm, the T cell activity should be reduced. So glucocorticoids can control the T cell activity so that cytokines are not excessively released. And among these cytokines, IL-6 is one of the important mediator which can be controlled by tocilizumab. So this drug acts as an antagonist at IL-6 receptors, thereby it can control the cytokine storm and inflammatory response. So this is one of the recent clinical uses of tocilizumab, but this drug previously used to control cytokine release syndrome. In the patients who are having the CAR T cells, chimeric antigen receptor T cells, these T cells, when they are excessively activated, they can release the cytokines, releasing in the cytokine storm, and again this is controlled by tocilizumab. Similarly, tocilizumab is indicated to control the inflammation in the rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is one of the autoimmune disorder which produce inflammation of the joints, resulting in the swelling as well as pain. In such conditions, tocilizumab can be given to control the inflammation. And this drug can be combined with the other agents like the disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. We have many of the drugs such as methotrexate, which modify the immune response, thereby control the inflammation. Along with such agents, tocilizumab can be used in the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. Another indication of this drug is the treatment of giant cell arthritis. So this is the inflammation of lining of arteries, particularly supplying to the head, resulting in the loss of vision, headache, and difficulty in the movements of jaw. So this inflammatory response again controlled by tocilizumab, where it reduces the immune response. Similarly, this drug can be used in the children with age greater than 2 years. So one of the clinical indication of this drug is in the treatment of polyarticular juvenile idiopathic arthritis. So this is just like the rheumatoid arthritis, which is observed in the children. That's why it is called as juvenile. And this is polyarticular, commonly known as PJIA. In this disorder, the inflammation is observed in greater than 5 joints within the 6 months of development of inflammation. So again, in this condition, swelling as well as pain of the joints can be observed, which can be controlled by tocilizumab. Similarly, this drug can also be indicated for systemic juvenile idiopathic arthritis, commonly known as SJIA. Again, this is observed in the children, that's why juvenile, but it is systemic. That means this situation produces inflammation of not only joints, other organs are also affected. So in this condition, inflammation of joints, liver, lungs and heart are also affected. So tocilizumab can be used for both polyarticular as well as systemic juvenile idiopathic arthritis, but it should be given in the children greater than 2 years. Now let us see how this drug acts. Interleukin 6 is one of the inflammatory mediator which can act by IL-6 receptors. So this cytokine produces two types of signalings. One of the pathways is the classical signaling pathway, which is not observed in all the cells. Second one is the trans signaling pathway. The classic signaling pathway is observed only in the hepatocytes and leukocytes, where it is mediated through the IL-6 receptors, which are present on the transmembrane and they are of subtype alpha. So they are indicated as MILR alpha. When IL-6 binds to these receptors, it produces the inflammatory response, but this is a protective inflammation. Similarly, IL-6 can act through the trans signaling pathway through the another type of IL-6 receptors. They are soluble in nature and denoted as SILR alpha receptors. These receptors are present on other somatic cells, and when they are activated, they can produce some pro-inflammatory response. In this way, interleukin 6 produces both inflammation as well as pro-inflammatory response, which is blocked by tocilizumab. So suppose this is a hepatic cell. On these hepatic cells, IL-6 receptor alpha are present. So IL-6, which is released by immune response, can bind to these transmembrane IL-6 receptors. But this complex is a weak complex. It is not stable. It can be stabilized by glycoprotein 130. So glycoprotein 130 acts as a co-stimulation, which can form a stable complex with the IL-6. And once this IL-6 bind to these GP130 as well as IL-6 receptor alpha, they are going to be dimerized. And these receptors are having the tyrosine residues, and they can activate one of the pathway, JAK pathway. This JAK pathway is the kinase pathway, which is going to phosphorylate the another transcription factor, STAT3. STAT3 is nothing but signal transducer and activator of transcription 3. So this is a transcription factor which can target the DNA within the nucleus. But initially they should be activated by phosphorylation, and here JAK can produce a phosphorylation of the STAT3. Once they are phosphorylated, they can undergo dimerization and they can interact with the DNA. And this interaction produces gene transcription, resulting in the protein synthesis. It can produce various types of proteins which produce proliferation as well as inflammation. They can also increase the apoptosis, and they can release few of the mediators like fibrinogen, which produce acute phase response. In this way, IL-6 can increase the proliferation as well as inflammatory response. Similarly, this gene transcription can also release another mediator, SOCS3. It is a suppressor of cytokine storm 3, which can control the JAK and STAT pathway such that excessive inflammation can be controlled. But during the cytokine release and in the autoimmune disorder, this negative feedback mechanism is not working properly, which results in the excessive inflammation. Now, tocilizumab is one of the IL-6 receptor antagonists. It can bind to these IL-6 receptors, thereby it can inhibit the action of IL-6, resulting in the decreased inflammatory response. In this way, tocilizumab can reduce the inflammation, but at the same time, it can also reduce the immune response. Now, let us see the precautions of tocilizumab. One of the important precautions of this drug is that this drug can produce gastrointestinal perforations. Because of these perforations, this drug can produce one of the condition, diverticulitis, which is the intestinal inflammation in the form of pouches. Because of these perforations, diverticulitis can be observed in the patients who are treated with tocilizumab. Similarly, we can observe the gastritis, inflammation of the gastric mucosa with this drug. So care should be taken in the patients who are already having any gastric inflammation. Just we have discussed that this drug can produce immunosuppression. So because of this, the T cell activity is going to be reduced. And when the T cell activity is going to be reduced, it reduces the immunity, which promotes the activation of bacteria as well as fungal infections. Particularly opportunistic infections are going to be increased by this tocilizumab, and this is a common effect observed with many of the immunosuppressants. So few of the opportunistic infections like tuberculosis, aspergillosis, candida, even cryptococcus infections may be increased with this drug. So during the treatment of this drug, development of these bacterial and fungal infections should be closely monitored because these are fatal to the patients. Similarly, this drug can also increase the gastroenteritis, bacterial arthritis, cellulitis, and even urinary tract infections can be increased because of this immunosuppression. Tocilizumab can affect the levels of few of the components. It can affect the levels of neutrophils. Similarly, it can affect the levels of platelets. And finally, it can also affect the lipids. Since this drug reduces the immune response, the neutrophil count is going to be reduced, resulting in the neutropenia. It can also reduce the platelet count, resulting in thrombocytopenia. But the lipids are going to be increased, particularly LDL cholesterol as well as HDL cholesterol are elevated. So this drug can increase the total cholesterol levels. So care should be taken to monitor neutrophil count as well as thrombocytes. When their levels are excessively suppressed, it results in the fatal effects in the patients. So care should be taken to monitor the neutrophils as well as thrombocytes in the patients. Similarly, tocilizumab can increase the liver enzymes. Alanine transaminase and aspartate transaminase levels are increased. So in the patients with hepatic failure, this drug should be carefully given because it produces further hepatic failure. Similarly, this drug may increase the risk of multiple sclerosis as well as few of the demyelinating disorders such as demyelinating polyneuropathy. Another important precaution of this drug is the hypersensitivity. Just like with the other drugs, this drug can produce hypersensitive reactions, particularly at the site of infusion. So it can produce erythema, urticaria, skin rashes, and even severe anaphylaxis can be observed with this tocilizumab. What are the side effects? The important side effects of this drug is the nasopharyngitis and upper respiratory tract infections. Other side effects include headache, dizziness, hypertension, bronchitis, gastritis, upper abdominal pain, mouth ulcers because of suppression of immunity, diarrhea, hypersensitive reactions like urticaria, skin rashes, erythema, and decreased neutrophil count resulting in the neutropenia, even decrease the platelet resulting in thrombocytopenia. These are the important side effects of tocilizumab. What are the contraindications? This drug can produce few of the hypersensitive reactions resulting in fatal anaphylaxis and even Stevens-Johnson syndrome. So in such hypersensitive reactions, this drug is contraindicated. How it is given? This drug is given by injection and available as solution. So it can be given by two routes of administration. It can be given by IV infusion, otherwise by subcutaneous route. But the dose and strength of the drug is not equivalent in these two routes of administration. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication as well as body weight and the route of administration. But before giving this tocilizumab, some minimum criteria should be achieved in the patient. Since this drug is going to reduce the neutrophil count, the absolute neutrophil count should be checked before the administration. This absolute neutrophil count should be greater than 2000 per square mm, and below the 2000, this drug should not be administered. Similarly, the platelet count should be greater than 1 lakh per square mm, and liver enzymes such as ALT and AST should not be elevated, and these liver enzymes should be less than 1.5 times of their upper normal limit. So this is the minimum criteria that should be achieved for administration of tocilizumab. So in the patients who are having elevated liver enzymes with 1.5 times of their upper limit and platelet count less than 1 lakh, neutrophil count less than 2000, in such conditions, this drug should not be administered. So that's about this tocilizumab, which is a humanized monoclonal antibody and acts as IL-6 receptor antagonist. It can block both soluble as well as transmembrane IL-6 receptor subtype alpha. Thereby, it can inhibit both inflammatory as well as pro-inflammatory response. So that's about this tocilizumab. In our next video, we will come with another interesting drug. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.